Now that we have looked at equimolar contour diffusion, so in equimolar contour diffusion, both of our component is diffusing at the same magnitude, but in the opposite direction. So the next one we'll be looking at is unimolecular diffusion. So by the name again, unimolecular meaning one molecule, meaning that mass transfer of component A occurs through a stagnant component B, meaning that here our NB is equal to zero, which means only A is diffusing and B is not doing anything, B is stagnant. Okay, therefore the total flux to or away from the interface, and here our NA, is same as our NA. A typical example of this case is evaporation of liquid with diffusion of the vapor from the interface into the gas stream. So we can see here, this is kind of our drying process. And then based on the definition of unimolecular diffusion, the general equation for diffusion plus the convection can be used, right? So we can still use this equation, our general equation. Na is equal to negative C dAb dxA over dz plus CA over C Na plus Nb. But we already mentioned that Nb is equal to zero, so we can just cancel out this term. And then we can convert our CA over C into xA, because do you know that this is also the formula for mole fraction. So we will get an equation in terms of xA, and we can know that this is the equation for Na. So if you see here, in order for us to find the value of Na, we need to know the value of Na. So it doesn't make sense, right? How can I find the value of something when I have to use that value to find it? So it doesn't make sense, okay? It's not logical. So what we need to do is that we have to rearrange and need to do some modification to this equation. So these are the steps that we do, okay? So I'm not gonna go into detail on how you do integrations and all these things, but this is our general equation. We change the Na, and we change it into our dx. So we have x, the term xA in one side, and terms Na in one side. We do integration and we'll get a general equation. Now this is the general equation for unimolecular counter diffusion in liquid phase. Why we say liquid phase? Because we have here xA and xAi. So xA and xAi again are the mole fraction at 0.1 and 0.2, depending on your diffusion path, on the diffusion length. So this is how you convert the general equation where we had the term Na on both sides to make it that we can actually find the value of total flux, where we have not only the molecular diffusion, but we also have convective diffusion. So if you are interested to know how to get this equation and to convert it into this equation, you are more than welcome to try to integrate it yourself. I would suggest you do that so that you have a better appreciation and understanding of this equation. So that was for liquid. But when we are talking about gases, most of the time we don't deal with concentration. We are dealing with pressure. And then when we are dealing with pressure, we are also dealing with our mole fraction. So usually mole fraction is no longer, we don't really consider the concentration, but we consider the partial pressure over total pressure. Now the same equation, we can do substitution first. We remove the value of CA and we put in the value of BA and YA. You'll get this first equation, okay? And we have here ln PB2 minus over ln PB1. So again here, as I've explained before this, if we have total pressure and we know the pressure of A at point 2, we can find the pressure of B at point 2 by just minusing total pressure minus pressure, partial pressure of A at point 2. And we can do the same thing, total pressure minus partial pressure of A at point 1, we can get partial pressure of component B at point 1. Okay, so this is actually called the logarithmic mean of PP1 and PP2. Be given something like this. So this one, it's actually similar to our logarithmic diameter when we were talking about IEK212, our heat transfer classes, where we used to find our logarithmic diameter when we were dealing with overall heat transfer coefficient. If you remember, the symbol for logarithmic diameter will be DL, right? So we need to find, in order for us to find the value of dl, we find the do minus di over ln do minus over di. So it is similar to our logarithmic mean of pressure. Okay, so if you know how to find the logarithmic diameter, you should be able to easily find the logarithmic pressure. Okay. So when we substitute the logarithmic pressure into this equation, we will get this final general equation for our unimolecular diffusion of in terms of gas. So we can have two equations. One is in terms of liquid and one in terms of gas. So which one you want to use is depend on the question that you are solving.